has come to a surprise that my great-grandfather Manuel L. Quezon was the president of the Philippines when our Filipino teacher gave this presentation to us 2 weeks ago. And I will be talking about the connections I happen to have with Manuel L. Quezon. Then we will go back in time with him to Las Islas Filipinas under the Spanish, then to the Philippine Islands under the Americans, till he led us to Philippines, a state of sovereignty and independence, in which I am even prouder as Filipino.
Born in the small town of Baler in the province of Tayabas, Manuel Luis Quezon was educated at an early age, learning Spanish at the age of 5. Quezon had finished a Bachelor's of Art degree with the highest honors at age of 16 at the Colegio of San Juan de Letran. He went on to study law and jurisprudence at the University of Santo Tomas, but got off to join the Philippine-American War for the Philippine independence. He returned to his studies after the capture and surrender of Emilio Aguinaldo.
Thanks to his education and thoughts that he developed, he grew into a man of justice and of high consciousness.
In 1905, he ran for governor in Tayabas and served 2 years before being elected a representative in the newly established Philippine Assembly. Between 1909 and 1916, he was appointed resident commissioner to the U.S. He was entitled to speak, but not to vote, in the U.S. House of Representatives. It was during this time that he pushed for and fought for the Philippine independence. Through his efforts, he obtained the passage of the Jones Act in the U.S. Congress, which granted Philippine independence but did not give a specific date as to when it would take effect. Quezon returned to Manila in 1916 to be elected into the Philippine Senate. 2 years later, he was Senate President. In 1922, Quezon became leader of the Nacionalista Party. In 1934, he returned to the U.S. and negotiated for the passage of Tidings-McDuffie Act, which set the date for full Philippine independence. The date was set 1946. For the 10 years in the run-up to independence, a Commonwealth government was provided for. In 1935, Quezon was elected as president of the Commonwealth government and Sergio Osmeña as vice president. Both were re-elected to their respective posts in 1941. During his presidency, Quezon tackled the problem of landless peasants in the countryside. Other major decisions include reorganizations of the island's military defense, promotion of settlement and development in Mindanao, proposals for land reform, and the tackling of graft and corruption within the government. With the outbreak of the war and the threat of Japanese invasion, Quezon and Osmeña established an exile government in the U.S. During his exile in the U.S., Manuel Quezon died of tuberculosis in Saranac Lake, New York. My great-grandfather Manuel L. Quezon is the founding father of the Quezon City, which is the government capital city. It is named after him. The Quezon Memorial Shrine was built in memory of his dream of a modern city and a modern nation.
So, December 17 of 1945, by virtue of Executive Order No. 79, His successor, President Osmeña, created the Quezon Memorial Committee. The function of that committee was to raise funds for the construction of a memorial shrine in honor of President Quezon. As envisioned, it consists of three main parts, the only one in the country. We have the museum, the Quezonian collection, the gallery, and the mausoleum, where we can find the remains of our president. This site was chosen to be his ultimate resting ground because since he was the founder of the city, it is just fitted to put his remains at the heart of the city he founded, at the heart of the seat of government centers in Quezon City. Base of the stairs to the top of the pylon stands 66 meters, which represents the number of age Quezon lived, 66 years, the height of the memorial. And the three angels symbolizes the three main islands of the Philippines, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. And the three angels, which you can see outside perched atop, no? That's Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. The structure is shaped in an equilateral, triangular base structure, like the strength of the pyramid, no? That depicts the 3 degrees of universal generation, which is the death, birth, life, and death.
As you have seen and heard, Manuel L. Quezon is amongst the highest citizens in the Philippine history and one of the few visionaries.
Is your name?
My name is Haris King Acidilio. Came from Calapan City Oriental, Mindoro. Okay.
Do you know who Manuel L. Quezon is?
Manuel L. Quezon is the first president of Commonwealth. He is one of the heroes in the Philippines.
Gandang hapon po. Sino po si Manuel L. Quezon? Sino po si Manuel L. Quezon?
Naging presidente ng Commonwealth. Yun po.
Afternoon, what's your name?
My name is Dan Pasha. I'm the organizer of the Green Pen Network.
Thank you. Can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Who is Manuel L. Quezon for you?
Well, he's the great one of our great, great Filipino who was the president before the war.
Hello, good afternoon. What's your name?
I'm Manuel Quezon.
Okay, can I ask you a question?
Yes.
Who is Manuel L. Quezon for you?
Manuel L. Quezon is the first president of the first Commonwealth of the Philippines. And thanks to him, I was named after him.
Hi, Tita. Give us your full name.
My name is Cynthia Estrada. I reside in Quezon City. I'm an environmentalist.
So tell me about what you think about Manuel L. Quezon.
Manuel L. Quezon was the president of the Commonwealth. He is our independence president. He was a champion for social justice, and he wrote a code of ethics for social equality, government service, and service for the poor.
What's your name?
Elena Tangkion.
Okay, sino po si Manuel L. Quezon?
Si Manuel L. Quezon po, siya yung first president of the Commonwealth at saka sa kanya po ipinangalan yung lugar na Quezon City at Quezon Province.
Ano pangalan mo?
I'm Mary Jane de la Cuesta.
Okay, sino si Manuel L. Quezon?
Si Manuel L. Quezon naging presidente ng Pilipinas and then lolo mo.
As a defender of freedom and justice, he manifested the dreams of all Filipinos, our independence. Manuel Luis Quezon, father of Philippine independence.